Greetings, welcome to the Great Solution Media. So in today's lecture of the robotics, we are going to design a home automation system. We can control or on off the home light by the just sending the message by the mobile. So for that we required a mobile phone. So we will send a message. LT1 means light will on, or LT0 means light will off. So we required a GSM module, microcontroller and relay and bulb and main AC lighting. So this bulb is connected by the AC mains, and this is on off through this relay, and through relay is controlled by the controller. This controller controlled by the GSM, and GSM module is controlled by your SMS.
So here we are discussing what are the equipment we required to design this project. So first we required mobile phone so that we can send the message from this mobile phone to on off the home light or home appliances. Second thing, we required this Arduino Uno kit. I am using here Arduino Uno R3 kit to control the GPS module and the relay through this mobile. And this is the GPS module. Here I am using GPS SIM 800C, 800C. It has IMI number. So through this IM number, it connect with the tower. So it should be registered with the IMI number only after this it will connect to the tower. So this is the SIM port. Here we are connecting a 3G SIM. This is BSNL 3G SIM. So I am connecting this SIM to this port. This is just like a Nokia phone like port. Previously we are connecting our SIM in the Nokia phones. So similarly I am connecting this SIM to this port. After that you can see here it has these are the input output pins. First is the ground pin. Second is the VIN pin. We can apply voltage 5 volt by the board also, but here we are applying external supply voltage because it will not work with the onboard supply as per my practical experience. Second is the transmit TXD and RXD signals, because it communicate with the Arduino board by the serial communication. So it required only two pins for communication, transmit and receiving. After that it has mic and speaker pins. Here we are not using the mic and speaker pins in this project. So look here, TXD and RX and ground we will connect in this. So we required only three connection: ground, RXD and TXD, because ground will connect with the Arduino pin to make a common ground. After that we will apply external supply to this board at this connector. For this we are using the 5 volt external supply. This is the 5 volt external supply voltage, sorry 12 volt 2 ampere supply voltage, 12 volt 2 ampere supply voltage. You can see here it required 12 volt 2 ampere supplies. It is written here, you can see here. So after that we required this relay, 5 volt control relay with single phase. It can control up to 250 volt. In India we have 220 to 240 supply voltage, so it can be control 250 10 ampere current, 250 volt 10 ampere current. So we are connecting here our main AC 240 volt, so it is okay for that. So these are the input pins for the external supply, means AC supply. Now after that we required a bulb. So this is the normal LED bulb which we are using in our home, and this wire. So initially these two wire are connected, and we just connect this switch to the main AC and it will on off through this our button there in the homes. But here we are cutting these two wires and it will connect with this relay from pin number 1 and pin number 2. You can see here how relayed work. You can go through my last relay lecture. So this is mobile is required for this project. It communicate with this GSM module. So we just send SMS to the SIM which is connected to the GSM module, that is 8827579830. We will send SMS to this number. We coded our message to on off our light, LT0 for the light off and LT1 for the light on of the home appliances.
First we need to common ground. So this common ground goes to the GSM module. After that we need to connect the transmitter and receiver pins. So this transmission pin goes to 7 number pin and this receiving pin goes to the 8 number pin of the Arduino. After that we need to connect the relay. So 5 volt supply goes to the relay and ground goes to the relay, and we are getting control pin from the 4 number pin here. And now these are the output pin of the relay. This goes to the bulb and second is goes to the main AC. So in this wire, this relay work as a switch. Okay, and this is GSM module.
Now come on the connections. The most important connection, the ground of the both Arduino and GSM module should be common. So pin number 1 of this GSM module is connected to the ground pin of the Arduino board. You can look here. This is going to the ground of the Arduino board. Because we are applying external supply to the GSM module, so this common ground is most important for this project. So we are applying a external supply by the 5 volt adapter 2 ampere, because this GSM module required 12 volt and 2 ampere supply voltage. So we are applying at this node or at through this connector. After that the supply to this Arduino board is providing by this USB. This board can be connected by the external supply also by this black connector, but here this board is communicating with this GSM module. Now we will connect the this transmitter and receiver pin because it will communicate through this serial communication. So it has TXD and RXD pins on board GSM module. So this TXD and RXD pin will connect with the Arduino board. This TXD is connected to the pin number 7 of this Arduino board, and RXD at connected at the pin number 8 of this Arduino board. You can look here. Now we will connect this relay. So the supply to this relay is given by the onboard Arduino board, because onboard Arduino board have a 5 volt and ground pins. So 5 volt supply is given to the relay by this Arduino board at pin number 1, and ground pin connected to third ground of this Arduino board at pin number 2 of the relay, and third pin, this near to the red LED, is the input pin or control pin of this relay. This control pin is connected to the Arduino board at the pin number 4. You can look here, this input pin or control pin is of this relay is connected to the pin number 4 of this Arduino board. You can count 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 means pin number 5th of this Arduino board, but at onboard they return a 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, so it connected pin number 4. Now we required this bulb, and this bulb is directed to connected to this AC. If we require to on off this bulb, but here we are controlling this bulb by the GSM module. So we are just cutting the any of the wire and these two wire are connected to the switch so that we can on off this bulb, and we are controlling this bulb by this relay. So these two wires will connect to the relay. So pin number 1 goes to the relay and pin number 2 are connected to these two wires of this relay. You can look here, pin number 1 and pin number 2's are the important. Pin number 3 we will left. Only pin number 1 and pin number 2 will connect these two wires to control this bulb, to on off this bulb through this Arduino. And Arduino get a signal or command by the GSM module.
So these are the connections for GSM module.
Come on the program. So in the program, first we need to include the software serial.h library. It contains the function of GPRS also. So we are creating a here two pins, 7 number and 8 number, at a data receiver and data transfer pins. Okay, now we are creating a relay control pin of the 4 number pin. So we are defining a relay is equal to 4 number pin. We also define here a character, name is in character, and after that we will define the valid setup. Okay, so now we will go on the byte setup. Now in the byte setup we are just define the pin mode of relay is out mode, because we are going to control the relay pin. After that digital write. Okay, so we are initially we are writing a on a relay is a low, means relay will be low, means your bulb will be off. Okay, after that we are going to start the GPRS. So GPRS begin will start here, 96 is the baud rate, and serial begin the GPRS with the baud rate 9600. So after the some delay we are testing our GPRS, whether it is on or off. So for this we are using the code. You can go through the my given link, so from where you can take all the codes for the GPRS enabling. So the this is the code 80. You can just write a 80, it will return a message by okay. Okay, but here we are writing a 80 plus CMGF is equal to 1. It shows the set SMS mode to text. So it shows the text SMS is on. Okay, so here we can also introduce some condition also, and we can see the condition, false condition at the serial monitor also. Okay, so but this programming is perfectly working, so I'm not going to checking here. Now first I like to delete all the previous SMS, so for that I am applying this loop here. So for the GPRS dot print, I am applying 80 plus CMGD is equal to 1 2 3 4 5, means it will delete all the message from all the memories from the available at the SIM. Okay, so previous SMS will delete by this loop condition. After the some delay I will read the print line, GPRS print ln by the 80 plus CNMT is equal to 2, 2, 0, 0, 0. It enable the SIM to start the reading the SMS, whatever available receive the SMS. So it started the received SMS. Okay, so we set up all the things. After that we will go for the loop, wide loop. So first, if GPRS available, if GPRS is available, after that, so whatever the value is available, we read the GPRS. This value will go in the in character. So we will read the value whether it is available, the LNT0 or LT1. Because here we are using, so we are using the two message, LT0 for the light off and LT1 to light on. Okay, so if message is LT1, so LT1 will go in the in character variable. So first character will check here if condition, if it, whether it is AL. So after some delay second character will check by this condition if it is T. Now these two character are the common character. After we will check
after some delay. If it is 0, so total character value is LT0. If it is OK, so we will on the off the delay, because 0, so delay will go low, and serial printer will also print the relay off. So this can be commented by you, because this is not an important command. Okay, this is only to check your relay condition at the serial printer. So we just open the serial printer and we can see there. So you can comment this also. After this, else if condition will go, because LT is the common character. So LF will check here the 1, if whether it is LT1, so relay will go on. After some delay, all the message will delete by this command, serial print ln. We can also use here in place of serial GPRS also, so it will delete all the commands. Okay, so all the message will delete by this command, and in this way this program will work. Now we will load this program. So initially light is on, so first we will off this light. So we'll write a low to write a low to this relay. So we'll change the program. So we are writing a low signal at this relay initially. So this initially it will off. So we are saving this, compiling this. Now we will load this program. So first is save and compile. Might load this program. So now it's loading. First it will compile, then compile, then load. So it's loading the program. When it will load, this light will off. So loading is done almost. So loading is completed, that's why you can see here, that's why this valve is off. Now we will control this valve, means this switch relay, by the SMS. Just we send the SMS to this GPS module, to this whatever the number the SIM of connected to this GPS module. We have a BSNL SIM MP, so it connected to MP network BSNL. It's connected to this Arduino kit. It communicate this Arduino kit. So Arduino kit will take signal from the GPS module, and this Arduino will control this relay, and relay will on off the main light or main bulb, that is on by the main AC. Now we will control this bulb by just sending the SMS. So we will send SMS to our number, to this SIM connected to GPS module, LT1, to on this light. So we are sending LT1 to on this light. You can look here. So now we are sending message. When it will received, this bulb will on. So we already sent this message. Okay, it is received. We get a signal received, and this bulb is on. You can see here, received the message, and this bulb is on. So this SMS is received by GPS module, and GPS module give a signal to the Arduino, or Arduino give a signal to the relay to on this bulb. So in this way we can automate our home appliances, every home appliance base, and we can control by just this relay and this mobile phone. Anytime now we will off this bulb, just sending the message LT0 to this GSM module or this SIM. So we already sent this message. When it will received, it will off. Okay, so it will received. We take gave a SMS message received, and this bulb is on off. Now again we can on this bulb, just sending the message LT1. So we are sending the message LT1 to on this. So we are sending the message to our number 8827579830, the BSNL number, that same is connected to this GSM module. We sent. Okay, so this module received this message, and this is on. So you can see here message is received by the SIM, that's why this bulb is on. So in this way we can control all the home appliances.